Have you ever wondered what really happens when a country puts a tariff on imported goods? I mean, we hear about it in the news all the time, right? Well, today we're going to pull back the curtain and break down the mechanics, step by step. We'll see how one little tax can change the whole game for local businesses and for your wallet. So here's the plan. First up, we're going to set the stage with a world of free and open trade. That's our before picture. Then, we'll throw a tariff into the mix and watch how that changes everything for producers and consumers. We'll even do the math on how much money the government makes from this. And finally, we'll zoom out and see how tariffs fit into the much bigger economic puzzle.
All right, so to really get the impact of a change, you first have to know what things looked like before, right? So let's establish our starting point, a market with totally free trade. No tariffs, no barriers, just open competition.
Now, for our explainer, we're going to make a key assumption. We're dealing with a small, open economy. Just think of it like this. Our country is one person shopping in a gigantic global supermarket. It can buy as much as it wants of something, but it's just too small to have any power to haggle over the price. The price is what it is, set by the world market, and our country is just a price taker.
This graph here shows us exactly what that looks like. You see, without any trade, the price would settle way up high where the domestic supply and demand curves cross. But with free trade, the global market steps in and pushes that price all the way down to the world price, which we call P star. And that, of course, is fantastic news for consumers. It means lower prices for everybody.
But at this lower world price, our local producers aren't quite as thrilled. They're only willing and able to produce this much of the good, the quantity we're labeling QS, for domestic supply. And it makes sense, you know, a lower price means less profit, so there's less incentive for them to produce a ton of it.
On the flip side, for consumers, that low price is a total steal, so they want to buy a whole lot more. You can see that where the demand curve meets the world's price line. We'll call this bigger amount QD for domestic demand.
So now we've got this gap, right? The people in the country want to buy way more of the product than the local companies are actually making. And how is that gap filled? You guessed it, imports. That big space you see on the graph is the total amount of stuff being brought in from other countries.
Okay, so our free trade baseline is crystal clear. We know how things work. Now, let's shake things up. It's time to see what happens when the government decides to step in and impose a tariff.
So, what exactly is a tariff? Well, at its core, it's really just a tax on things you buy from other countries. Governments use them all the time, maybe to protect their own industries or just to make some money. For what we're talking about, it's a fixed cost, we'll call it T, that gets added to every single item that crosses the border.
And the effect is immediate. The tariff gets slapped right on top of the world price. So the new price that everyone in the country pays is the old world price, P star, plus the tariff, T. Just like that, the price of the imported good has gone up.
So the government just flipped a switch and made the product more expensive. What happens now? How do local businesses and everyday shoppers react to this new economic reality?
Well, the market basically gets pulled in two opposite directions. On one hand, domestic producers see that higher price and think, hey, we can make more money now. So they start making more stuff. But at the exact same time, consumers see that higher price and decide to buy less. Let's see how that plays out on the graph.
For local producers, that higher price is a huge incentive. They can sell their products for more, which encourages them to ramp up their output. We see their production move up along the supply curve to a new, higher level.
But for us, the consumers, that same price hike means the product now takes a bigger bite out of our budget. So what do? We cut back. And you can see that as demand moves down along the demand curve to a new, lower quantity.
So let's put those two pieces together. Local producers are making more, and local consumers are buying less. And because of that, the gap between what's wanted and what's made at home gets a whole lot smaller.
And here's the bottom line, plain and simple. The volume of imports shrinks. This isn't some accident or a weird side effect. It's the direct, unavoidable result of the tariff. In fact, most of the time, that's exactly what the policy was designed to do in the first place.
So we've seen how tariffs hit producers and consumers, but there is one other major player in this whole game we haven't talked about yet, the government. So let's figure out what they get out of all this.
So where does the government actually fit into this picture? I mean, it's their tax, after all. What's in it for them?
Well, the math is actually pretty straightforward. The government's revenue is just the size of the tariff, T, multiplied by the new, smaller number of imports.
every single imported unit that comes in has to pay that tax. And all that cash goes straight to the government.
And on our graph, this is so easy to see. See that purple rectangle there? Its height is the size of the tariff, T, and its width is the new, smaller volume of imports. That entire shaded area is the total amount of money the government collects from this tariff. Okay, we've gone through the nitty-gritty mechanics of how a tariff works. Now, let's zoom out and put this whole thing into a bigger economic context, because this is where it gets really interesting. Here's something kind of mind-blowing. From a purely economic standpoint, the effect of a tariff isn't unique. The result, a higher price inside the country, is exactly the same thing that would happen if the world price for that good suddenly shot up, or if the country's currency lost value, making all imports more expensive. The market doesn't actually care why the price went up.
And this really is the crucial takeaway here. The market just reacts to the new, higher price. It doesn't care about the reason behind it. So whether it's a government imposing a tariff, or a global supply chain problem, or a change in the currency exchange rate, the end result for producers and consumers is identical.
And that leaves us with one last thing to chew on. If the economic effects on the ground are completely identical, how much does the reason for that price increase really matter? Is there a difference between a deliberate policy choice like a tariff and some external market force nobody can control? That's something for all of us to think about.